Hello and welcome to this video tutorial for the dot painting art directions and templates to accompany the song Australia by John Riggio from Music A8 Volume 28 Number 3. In order to participate in this activity, you'll need to download the PDF directions, which are in the graphics and extras section for this issue. And the 7-page PDF includes the directions as well as the animal templates. The materials you'll need to complete this project are tempera paint, paper, cotton swabs, a water sprayer if you want to do the splatter outline option, smocks, and old newsprint if needed. This art activity was inspired by Aboriginal dot painting, and we encourage you to Google the term Aboriginal dot painting for additional lesson plans and other resources if you want to expand the project. So you have three options to give to your students for this project, and they vary in the length of time it'll take to complete, as well as the messiness factor, and also the level of creativity for your students. The first option is the hand outline, and we have directions for the splatter outline or the drawn hand outline. The splatter outline is definitely messier and more time consuming, but it does replicate the blown hand art that's found in Aboriginal caves, so it's a neat extra level of authenticity to this project. And then there's the drawn hand outline. And then free draw, which is a great option for older students or if you want to give your students a little bit more creative leeway with this project. And then there are the animal templates, which is the quickest and cleanest option for your students. So this first half of the directions is only applicable to the hand outline splatter paint option. The second half of the directions applies to all the different options that are available for your students. So we will, here, let me show you this is the finished project. And these are both the example of the splatter paint option. This version here, I did a little experiment to see if it was necessary to do white dots first and then add the color paint, and it's not necessary. The color paint shows up just fine on the black construction paper. But as you can see here, depending on how you use the different colored dots, you can actually make shapes within the silhouette of whatever it is that you've chosen to do, be it the hand, free draw, or animal templates. So starting with the hand outline splatter paint option, you'll have your students place their hand firmly on the black construction paper, and they do need to press down. The mixture in your water sprayer is, the ratio is 3/4 white paint to 1/4 water, and you may need to play with that a little bit depending on your sprayer. You want the paint to be able to spray out nicely but not be so watered down that it doesn't show up on the black construction paper. So, one more little hint. With tempera paint, if you have about 3/4 of a cup of paint to 1/4 of a cup of dishwashing soap, liquid dishwashing soap, it makes it much easier to clean up, and it makes it easier to come off of the hands too. So you have your mixed up mixture of paint and water, and your students have placed their hand firmly on the black construction paper, and then you will take your paint water mixture and spray, and you'll mist the area around the hand as well as the hand itself, and then have your students pull their hand up straight up, and if they press down hard enough, you'll get this outline, the silhouette of the hand on the paper, and this mimics the blown hand art that you can find in Aboriginal caves. If you don't press down hard enough, you can see here, sometimes the paint will bleed underneath the areas where their hands have not been pressed down, so make sure your students press down hard enough. So that is the first step, and if you are choosing this option, you'll have to wait until the paper is dry before you can move on to step two. So step two is applicable to all the different options that you have. You'll want to discuss with your students why it is that certain colors will show up better on a darker background while other colors will show up better on a lighter background. So once your students choose the colors that they want to use, they will use a cotton swab, and you'll use the cotton swab kind of like you would a stamp. You'll want to go straight down into the paint, and you'll want to dip the paint only on the very tip of the cotton swab. So you'll dip down into the paint, and then you'll dip down onto the paper. And if you do this straight up and down motion, you will make little dots here. And you'll want to have your students focus on being patient and working slowly, and they'll want to space the dots evenly, and that makes the cleanest looking imprints. So you'll want to start on the outside. You can see here, you'll want to start on the outside of the shape that you're working on and do one color. And for every layer, as you go towards the inside of the silhouette, you'll choose a different color. And you can see here that depending on the colors that you choose, you can make these different shapes within the silhouette, which is fun. And that's pretty much it for the project. Like I said, the second half of the directions are applicable to your other option is the drawn hand outline. So instead of doing the splatter paint, students will just place their hand on the piece of paper, draw around their hand to get the hand outline, and then do the dot painting from there. You can also do a free draw, so students draw any shape that they like, and then within the shape, they'll mimic each layer of the dot painting. This was just done with markers, just to show you quickly how you do the different layers. But so students are able to choose any shape they'd like. And then lastly, we have some pre-made animal shapes of animals native to Australia. And the students can use this outline instead of their hand and do the dot painting within the silhouette of the different animals. And we have a kangaroo, a sea turtle, a lizard, and a snake. And that's pretty much it. Thank you so much for watching. We appreciate you being loyal Music K8 subscribers.